Hi students, today we'll discuss on microstrip lines. Okay, so before going into microstrip line, let me give some idea on strip line. So generally the strip lines are used to interconnect microwave devices to make a microwave system. So strip line is a three conductor transmission line. So it is a three conductor transmission line, means this is one conductor and these two are another conductors. So this is the cross sectional view of strip line structure. So strip line generally consists of a central thin conducting strip which has some width W and thickness T. The width is greater than thickness T and this strip line is placed inside a low loss dielectric substrate of thickness B by 2 between two ground planes that can be seen here. Okay, so usually thickness of metallic central conductor and metallic ground planes, they are same. The thickness of this and the thickness of these two, this is above ground plane and this is bottom ground plane. So the thickness of this strip line and the thickness of top ground plane and bottom ground plane, both of them, they are same. And the width of the ground plane is 5 times greater than the spacing between the two ground planes. Okay, now we'll see how it operates. So generally the voltage is applied between the center of the strip and a pair of ground plane. Okay, so that as soon as the voltage is applied between the center of the ground plane and between two center of the strip and between two ground planes, the current starts flowing. Current flows down the center strip and it returns via the ground plane. So it will flow like this and it will return via the ground plane. So since the structure is open at both ends, see above and below you have two ground planes, but at sides you don't have any ground plane. Since it is open at both the ends, it is also called as non-radiating transmission line. And since it has both electric and magnetic field inside, so you can say the dominant mode of strip line is TEM mode. So what is TEM? Is transverse electric and magnetic mode. Means electric and magnetic field components are transverse to the direction of propagation. And whatever field lines here we are able to see, all of them, they are confined within the transmission line with no radiation loss. There are no field line which are outside this. All of them, they are confined within this region. So there will be no radiation loss. And all the field lines, they are concentrated near the strip line and they decay exponentially towards the ground plane, which are at zero potential. So the strip line is constructed using a printed circuit board. Okay, the dimension of the strip lines, they are chosen such that it has to operate with minimum loss. So even the higher order modes are also able to propagate, but the higher order modes can be propagated by ensuring or by selecting the dimensions of the strip line. That means the dimensions of the dimensions must be less than lambda d by 2. So lambda d is nothing but the wavelength in dielectric medium. So the commonly used dielectric means this is the dielectric. Okay, this is placed on a dielectric substrate which will have some dielectric constant. So the generally used dielectrics are Teflon and polystyrene. And the strip line will operate at a frequency of 100 megahertz to 100 gigahertz. So how to find the impedance of a strip line? So generally the impedance of strip line is inversely proportional to the ratio of width of the inner conductor to the distance B between the ground planes. So width W, it is the ratio of, this is the width W of the inner conductor. It is the ratio of width of the inner conductor to the distance between these two ground planes. Okay, so it is, the formula is given by Z naught is equal to 94.15 by square root of epsilon r into W into K by B plus CF by 8.8854 epsilon whole to the power minus 1 ohms. So this is relative permittivity. This is width of the inner conductor, I mean width of the strip line, and this is the spacing between the two ground plates, and where k is a constant which is equal to 1 by 1 minus t by b. T is thickness, b is the distance, and the cf is the fringing capacitance. It is due to the fringing electric field at the edges of the strip. Okay, so what are the higher order modes? What about the higher order modes? So here the strip line is capable of propagating even the other modes also. So generally the upper cutoff frequency is limited by the two dominant modes of TE and TM wave. So we know the dominant mode of TE is TE10 and the dominant mode of TM wave is TM11. So for TM11, the cutoff wavelength is given as 2b square root of epsilon r. And for TE10 mode, the cutoff wavelength is given as 2w plus pi b by 2 into square root of epsilon r. As we know, what is b? It is a separation between two ground planes. It is a separation between two ground planes. So this is b. Okay. Next, w is width of the inner conductor and epsilon r is relative permittivity or dielectric constant of a dielectric substrate. So we'll have some losses in the strip line. So the two types of losses here is we observe is dielectric loss and conductor loss. So generally the total attenuation is nothing but sum of this dielectric loss and conductor loss. So this is attenuation constant, this is conductor loss, and this is dielectric loss. So conduction loss is given Rs by Z0 into B pi W by B plus ln 4B by pi T by ln 2 plus pi W by 2B Nepers per length. Similarly, the formula for dielectric loss is alpha d is equal to pi by lambda naught square root of epsilon r tan delta Nepper per length. So the total loss is given by alpha c and alpha d. Okay. Now this is about microstrip line. Since it has some losses, we go for microstrip line. See, it is a simple geometry. It consists of a thin conductor and a ground plane separated by a low loss dielectric substrate. So you can say this microstrip as an unsymmetrical strip line. Why? Because the upper ground plane is not present and hence it is called as open strip line. So when you see the strip line, it will have two ground planes. This is one ground plane and the above one is the other ground plane. But here if you see, there is only one ground plane, the bottom one, means this is not covered by another ground plane. Okay. So what is the advantages of not having the upper ground plane? So if there is no upper ground plane, the complete conductor pattern may be deposited on and processed on a single dielectric substrate, which is supported by a single ground plane. Now fabrication cost would also be less. Okay. And the second advantage is we can easily mount all active and passive devices, and even you can make minor adjustments after the circuit is fabricated on this strip line. Okay, so again, this is also fabricated using the printed circuit techniques, and the commonly used dielectric material here is alumina, quartz and duroid. So there the dielectric commonly used dielectric materials for a strip line is Teflon and polystyrene, and the commonly used dielectric materials for micro strip line is aluminum, quartz and duroid. So if we want to fabricate the semiconductor devices on a micro strip line, it is better if we use silica. Why? Because silica has the dielectric constant value 11.8. So what is the use of using the high dielectric constant? Means it will reduce the amount of fringing fields. So what are these fringing fields? Means see, when you operate this, what happens is the electric field line, since there is no upper ground plane, the electric field lines will remain above, I mean outside, and a few lines will be inside. Of course, all of them, they decay towards the bottom ground plane. So these are called as fringing fields. So since upper plane is not existing, they remain partially in air and partially in dielectric substrate. So here, what is the dominant mode means? Since half of the electric field lines are lying in the air and half of them are lying below the strip line, This is called as quasi-TEM mode. So the dominant mode here is quasi-TEM mode. So most of the, most of the electric field lines, they are concentrated below the strip line. So pure TEM mode cannot propagate in microstrip line, rather quasi-TEM mode will propagate in microstrip line. So because of this open structure, it radiates EM energy. So the other parameter is effective dielectric constant. So the propagation field lines, this propagation field lines, they partially lie in air and in dielectric substrate. So the delay time, the propagation delay time is decided by this effective dielectric constant, because the quasi-TEM mode is controlled by this effective dielectric constant. Quasi-TEM mode is nothing but the dominant mode of a microstrip line. So why it is quasi means, because the electric and magnetic field lines, they are partially in air and partially below the strip line. So the formula for this effective dielectric constant is epsilon r plus 1 by 2 plus epsilon r minus 1 by 2 into 1 plus 12 h by w whole to the power minus half. And we know epsilon r is nothing but relative permittivity, and h here is nothing but it is the spacing between the microstrip line and the ground plane, and w is nothing but the width of the strip line. So what is the characteristic impedance? So the characteristic impedance of a microstrip line is a function of strip line width, thickness and ground plane separation. So the formula for characteristic impedance is 60 by square root of effective dielectric constant ln 8h by w plus w by 4h ohms if w by h is less than or equal to 1. So the guide wavelength is also given by formula, that is lambda naught by square root of effective dielectric constant. So here also we will be having losses. So the losses of microstrip line here is, we will be having three types of losses. One is dielectric loss, and the other one is ohmic loss, and the other one is radiation loss. So what is this dielectric loss? See, generally all dielectric materials will have some conductivity. So, but that conductivity will be very small. So when conductivity is considerable, then it cannot be neglected. So at that time, we'll get this loss. So means when electric and magnetic field, they will not be in time phase. So at that time, you'll be getting this dielectric loss. So the dielectric attenuation constant is given as sigma by 2 square root of mu by epsilon. Now the other loss, the second loss is ohmic loss. So what is this ohmic loss means? This ohmic loss is due to the non-perfect conductors. So the current density in the conductors of a microstrip line, it is generally concentrated this skin thick inside the conductor. So that conducting attenuation constant is given as 8.6 RS by Z0 into W, where RS is surface skin resistance, Z0 is characteristic impedance, and W is width of microstrip line. Now what is the radiation loss? So radiation loss means generally depends on substrate thickness and dielectric constant. So the radiated power loss is generally given as radiated power is 240 pi square into h by lambda naught into f by z naught into pt. What is this h means? It is simply the spacing or the distance between the ground plane and microstrip, and f is nothing but the radiation factor. Z naught is nothing but the characteristic impedance, and lambda naught is nothing but free space wavelength. So next is quality factor. What is the quality factor of a microstrip line? So quality factor is nothing but it is a measure of frequency selectivity. Okay, so the quality factor of a microstrip will be generally very high. But the value of a Q of a microstrip line, it is limited by the radiation loss of both substrate and dielectric constant. So the Q factor is given by a formula, 0.63 H square root of sigma into F, where this is the conductivity, this is the operating frequency, and H is distance between ground plane and microstrip line. So finally, coming to the limitations of the microstrip line, what are the limitations means? The relative dielectric constant will change due to the temperature variation. So when dielectric constant of a dielectric substrate changes with the temperature, then the impedance will also change. So that is one of the limitations. and we know the size is inversely proportional to the frequency. So when you go for high frequencies, the size will be very less. So at high frequency, since the dimensions of a device, they are very small, so it will face fabrication problems. So since microstrip line do not have the top ground plane, it is open in nature. So this openness will result in radiation loss. Okay, so this is about strip line and microstrip line. Thank you.